So I've been getting a lot of questions from some of you about either setting up two-factor authentication on two devices or migrating from one device to another. Say you've bought a new phone and you need to move your 2FA codes to that new phone. It's not a difficult process, thankfully, but you do need to be very careful. So in this video, I'm gonna share with you three important things that you need to know before you get started and then walk you step by step through the process of transferring all of those codes in just a couple of minutes. Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and let's begin with those three quick but very important concepts you need to understand before you migrate your Google Authenticator codes. First, because these codes are simply a mathematical equation, it's not something that Google just creates and then gives you. If you lose access to these codes, there is no forgot password link that you can click. Google cannot help you retrieve lost 2FA codes. In other words, don't throw away your old codes, or delete the authenticator app, or sell that old device until you're absolutely sure that you've migrated them over successfully. That brings me to my second point. If I were you, I would use this as an opportunity to make sure that you have the backup of all of these codes if you don't already. This might mean going back through every single account individually and resetting the 2FA authentication codes and then actually storing the backup codes that they give you, which unfortunately, let's be honest, most people don't do. For example, you see here on Twitter how it gives me a QR code, and then after I scan and verify the code as part of the setup, they'll give me this 12-digit backup code. That's what you're looking for. Find a good place to collect and store those codes, obviously someplace other than your phone. Personally, I use 1Password to store my 2FA codes instead of Google Authenticator, but I also simultaneously set up Authy, which is another free alternative to Google Authenticator as my backup in case something were to happen to 1Password. Which leads me to my third and final point before we jump into the migration tutorial. Most people don't realize that during the setup process, you can easily set up more than one device or even authenticator apps. This whole time-based one-time passcode is a math system. So these companies don't even know, or for that matter, care how many times you scan that code. You can literally sit there and scan the QR code with your phone, your wife's phone, your iPad, your kid's iPad, all at the same time. And if you've done it right, you'll notice that they all spit out the exact same 6-digit code every 30 seconds. It's beautifully simple, but very secure math. All right. In this tutorial, I want to cover two primary ways that you can migrate your 2FA codes out of the Google Authenticator app, but this is important. You need to have your original codes with you. So if you've lost access to your phone or already sold it, you have a completely different problem that we're not covering in this video. So I'm really sorry about that. While Google Authenticator doesn't sync your 2FA codes, they do give you the ability to export them to a single QR code that you can easily scan into your new phone or tablet. So to do this, simply open your Google Authenticator app and click on the three dots here you see on the upper right. This gives you two options to choose from, and obviously we're going to want to click on Export Accounts. You'll get a quick warning that you can only export 10 accounts at a time, but all this means is that if you have more than 10 2FA codes, you'll have to go through this process more than once in order to get them all moved over. You now choose which codes you want to export, which in my case will be all of them, and then click Export. You see this massive QR code that you can either immediately scan or screenshot for later use. When you click done, Google Authenticator is going to give you this option to remove all your accounts. Now, you're welcome to do that if you want, but my recommendation is to dismiss this and wait until you've verified your codes before removing all the accounts on your old device. Now, let's say I want to set up Google Authenticator on my new iPad. I'm going to click Get Started and then scan QR code, or I'll click that plus if you've already set up Google Authenticator. You'll see that the moment I scan the QR code, all of the codes show up. Now, if I lay my phone and iPad side by side, you'll see that all of the codes are the exact same and they change in unison every 30 seconds. Two quick notes about this exported QR code. First, it only works with Google Authenticator. I've tried importing it into Authy or Microsoft Authenticator and it's just not compatible. Second, if you want, you can store this QR code as your backup somewhere. You can print it off or save it on a USB drive that you keep in a safe. I don't know, whatever floats your boat, but this QR code doesn't expire. So that's the easy way to export and migrate your two-factor authentication codes. The manual method is a bit more time intensive since you'll be dealing with each account individually, but it will be necessary if, for instance, you're trying to export to a different authenticator app other than Google's, which honestly, that's what I recommend, or if you feel like your codes have been compromised in some way. I'm going to use Twitter again as an example, but you have to realize that each account setup will look a little bit different. You just need to log into your individual account and find the security settings for 2FA. Here on Twitter, I have to click on Settings and Privacy, then over here on security and account access, and then finally on security. You're gonna see where they have two-factor authentication, and when I click in there, it shows that it has been set up, which is good. Again, different dashboards treat this differently, but your goal is to either turn off 2FA and then set it back up again, like you see me doing here in Twitter, or to simply manage or add a new 2FA authenticator. In every instance that I've done this, I've never been able to access the original QR code that was used to set up my original device. Instead, I just have to reset and start from scratch or add a new code as a security option. Earlier today, I personally just finished this manual process, moving all my 2FA codes to a new device, and I feel your pain right now. I had about 15 2FA codes and it took me about 20 to 30 mind-numbing minutes to get it all switched over and verified. But now I've created backups and I feel confident enough to delete Google Authenticator on my old phone and then be done with it. My hope is that you can feel confident to do the same. If this tutorial was helpful, give it a thumbs up, and I always do my best to answer any questions in the comments below.